how there's more people that have died, not only in your county, but in the entire country of opioid deaths. But we have a daily press conferences with Mr. Polancarz on COVID. I can tell you the biggest issue in both cases is the lack of accountability for our people that are were appointed to oversee those issues. I can tell you it certainly doesn't help the opioid crisis with the open border and bringing the migrant crisis here and allowing this free fall of fentanyl coming across our borders. So we have to get serious about closing the borders, we have to get serious about the migrant crisis, and we have to get serious about the mental health services and the root of the problems that come around with opioids. People have less money in their pockets, people have a higher rate of depression, a lot of debt because of COVID, and we have serious economic issues, we have serious mental health issues that play a major role in that opioid addiction, and it needs to be addressed.
Thank you. Your rebuttal, Mr. Holder. Once again, she gave you inaccurate information.
No people in our country did not die from COVID over the course of the 3-year period of COVID. There's more people did not die. I know exactly how many people died. There are more than 3,000 individuals who died between March of 20 and March of 23 as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic in Erie County alone. And the estimate was we had over 6,000 die in the first 6 months if we had not taken action to shut down and protect our community. There are not more than 3,000 people who died in Erie County from opioid epidemic in the same period. We worked very hard to get our community, talking to the community. The work that we've done has been replicated elsewhere. The problem is it's changed. It's no longer something with addictive prescription drugs that's causing it. It's individuals using cocaine, habitual cocaine users that are now spiked with fentanyl and dying. And we're working with the rest of it.
Thank you.